Hello, hope you're having a good day. I'm TR Rose, and I am late to the game. So when I was a kid, I had these beautiful Disney princess dolls made by Mattel. And I had Cinderella and Belle and Jasmine, and I loved all their outfits. And I always thought, wouldn't it be fun if I also had a Princess Peach that I could put next to Cinderella and Belle and all those other beautiful ladies? But they have never made a Princess Peach fashion doll. Well, maybe that's changed now. Stay tuned. It all started when I was talking with my friend Cody on Instagram, and he was showing an amazing collection of Princess Peach dolls that he had imported from Mexico. There were a whole lot of different ones, and they almost looked homemade. Well, not quite homemade, but not exactly factory produced. There were lots of variations, all different hairstyles and dresses. I'd never seen anything like it. So Cody sent me the name of the eBay seller who had procured these dolls for him, and I set about ordering a set of three for myself. There were far too many for me to get them all, but I looked through Cody's collection and I picked out three that really stood out to me. So while I was waiting for my package to arrive, I tried to do some research on these dolls to see if I could find anything similar out there on the internet. And this led me to a Reddit post made by a user called SparkAxolotl, who had found one of those same peach bootlegs at a Mexican outdoor shop. According to their post, these fakie dolls first started to appear when Rainbow High first became popular. So they kind of emulate that style with the larger heads and the skinnier bodies. They have characters like Miraculous Ladybug, Coraline, or even a girl version of Pennywise the Clown. The dolls themselves don't appear to have been knocked off from the same source. So the body looks like it doesn't exactly match the head. The head is likely a knockoff of a Sophia the First doll. I also found some listings where you can order this exact same style of doll, but wearing traditional Mexican clothing, especially some painted like sugar skulls. As I don't live in Mexico, I don't know how popular these are or how commonplace they are at markets. I have seen lots of bootlegs out there, but nothing like this in person. First thing in here are three hoop skirts to go with the dolls. These are really interesting. They're made of mesh and there's a wire in the bottom to make the dresses stand out. Okay, that's really cool. Oh, and then we've got little stands where the feet go through. And then I ordered three dolls. There were lots more that I saw, but I only chose the three that I liked best. And these were a lot bigger than I expected. I was expecting something about Barbie size. So here's this one. I think she looks kind of shy with her bangs. She's very cute. Here's this one. She's got like an overlayer on her dress with sparkles. She's got a ponytail. And this one looks really fancy. She's got sequins and very, very long hair. These are all in individual bags. So let's get this box out of here. And here are the three beautiful dolls. Let's start by opening up this girl here. Sort of has some product in the front of her hair. She's got little earrings. Little pink dangly earrings here. Velcro on the back of the dress. There seems to be a lot of hair here. You can see, if you move it, you can see through the hair a little bit, but honestly, not that bad. It's very thin plastic, though. It's not the thicker vinyl like a Barbie doll, but
she can twist her head. Body twists. She has tiny little dark pink shoes that I don't believe are removable. And she has a crown with a comb on the bottom. So this is doll number one. Now let's open up this one. Okay, and she has a high ponytail, long, long, long yellow hair. She has white as attached to the bottom of her sleeves to represent the gloves. This one doesn't have a jewel on the front as the other two do. Arms move. But she does have a sparkly sheer overskirt over top of the pink, so that's neat. And she has the same crown as her sister. Because of the ponytail, that goes in a little bit better. She's got straight across the front bangs. She's looking off to the side too. Looks like there was something maybe filed off back here. This is a little bumpy. Doll number two. And then here is doll number three with the very, very long hair. This crown actually looks bigger than the one on her two sisters. Look at all that hair she has. This is straight up Rapunzel hair, all the way down to the floor, and curly too. Very thick hair on this one also. She has a glittery jewel in the front. She's got sequins. Sequiny fabric for the darker parts of pink. She doesn't have shoes, but she's got some sort of tights. That is a lot of hair. She's got a widow's peak in the front of her hairline, and there's her nice big crown. And she's looking more straight ahead. The other two are kind of looking off to the side and up, but she is looking right at the camera. Maybe she's the top ranking member of this particular Peach Army. So there we have three beautiful Princess Peaches. The hoop skirts are interesting, but it doesn't seem like they go quite long enough on some of them. Like the hoop comes down to here. It seems like the hoop's a little too wide to fully fit all the skirt. And I'm wondering if I should just keep this as is, display it without the hoop, or maybe make some slight modifications myself. Still trying to decide that. So here's Peach number one. Peach number two, her dress doesn't quite come down long enough to cover the whole hoop. It looks like there's plenty of skirt. It's a little short. She also has little white pearly shoes that don't come off. And finally, here's the sequin peach. Again, it's sticking out here and not down here. Seems that this is either a little bit too short or a little bit too wide. But it does make her skirt stick out very nice.
I did wind up shrinking down the size of the hoop skirts, which I did by seam ripping some of the netting fabric, using wire snips to make the wire for the hoop a little bit smaller and then bending it back into place, then sewing it back together. I think it makes them display a lot better. I love that they included hoop skirts with these dolls because it really helps the dresses display better. So here is long-haired Rapunzel-style Peach with her reduced-width hoop skirt. Here is shy Princess Peach with her smaller hoop. And here's Ponytail Peach. Her dress was much larger than the other two, so I didn't have to reduce it quite so far to get the hoop to fit under the dress. While I love these dolls, especially their uniqueness, and the fact that they represent a character who doesn't otherwise have a fashion doll, the quality is not the best. The hair is a bit thin. If you look in the back, you can see where the hair was rooted. The bodies are very flimsy, and there's not really any articulation to speak of. The heads do turn, and the arms move up and down, but you can tell this is a very thin blow mold style of plastic. These really aren't collector's items, but they are an interesting curiosity. The jewelry for the two out of the three that I have that have the brooch on the front, the brooch setting appears to have been made out of fun foam. When you see mass-produced Princess Peach items, they always have the same face, but these all have different expressions. One of them looks very confident. One of them looks shy. Their hairstyles are all yellow, but they're even different kinds of yellow, and they have different hairdos. There's different fabrics for the dresses. So I'm really happy that I was able to add these to my collection, but now that I have a few, I can't see adding any more. But what this did do is it inspired me to create my very own Mattel-style Princess Peach doll. So to make this, I got an Ariel doll from an eBay lot. So I decided to re-hair her. I styled it up in curls, and I bought some patterns for making doll clothes so I could make my very own Princess Peach just the way I really wanted one. But that brings me to an interesting question. Why hasn't Nintendo ever produced a line of princess fashion dolls? I know I'm surely not the only person who would want these. I mean, if you just made Princess Peach, you could make all of her outfits from the Super Mario Brothers movie. You could make her power-ups from the games. You could make all of her transformations from Princess Peach Showtime. But that's not the only princess that they have at their disposal. Why not add in Daisy, Rosalina, Pauline? Why not do a whole series of Princess Zelda? There's so much to choose from. To me, it really seems like a missed opportunity because I know collectors, like me, would happily buy the whole set. So I hope you've enjoyed this look at a very unique collectible bootleg item. If you enjoyed today's video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more content like this. Most importantly, I hope you had fun.